Alright guys, the time has come on the channel where we need to set it straight once and for all. Are you over or under? You heard right, a complete video on your roll of toilet paper. It seems like it's a worldwide debate on whether your toilet paper or toilet tissue should be installed with the leading edge towards you or away from you. And yeah, it's a personal preference thing, but after watching this video, you might just change your habits, or maybe you just don't give a crap. Haha, give a crap. Get it? Oh. So when Seth Wheeler, the creator of the roll of toilet paper, illustrated the patent to his futuristic idea in 1891, it clearly showed the leading edge of the paper was over and not under. But it was never specified anywhere that it couldn't be used in the under position, leaving place to this worldwide controversial debate that everyone's arguing about. In time, studies have shown that 60 to 70% of the population prefers to use the over method rather than the under, and have all of the facts to back up their choice. So I decided to make a video on all the pros and cons about either way of installing it, and in the end, I'll leave it up to you to decide if it's worth changing or not. Also, I'd like to hear your way of installing it at home and why you do it that way by commenting after the video. So without further ado, let's get started. So why use the under method? The truth of it all is that there aren't that many pros to doing it this way, unfortunately. One good reason that came to mind would be to get some form of revenge over your significant other. But that doesn't really count, I guess. Secondly, from what the internet say, a lot of people with cats have complained that they have less of a tendency to unreel the whole roll when it's under, which is a plus. Another reason the internet's pulled out is when using the over method in an RV or recreational vehicle. A lot of people notice that when using the under method in an RV, it doesn't roll out as much as the over method. Now, is this really true? We'll let the RVers take care of that. And surprisingly enough, that's all I could think of for the pros. Now, let's move on to the cons. Let's face it, when you wipe your ass, you most likely get some germs or even bacteria such as E. coli on your hand, and the fact that the paper clings to the wall, those germs have now been transferred onto that same wall for the next candidate without you even noticing, which is kind of yucky. This would only be avoidable if you were to grab the paper in this fashion every time, which honestly looks kinda creepy and no one actually does it. The next reason is not having a direct relation with the seams. Personally, I always take the same amount of paper for each wipe, which is 4 sheets on a normal day and 5 or 6 sheets on a Willy Wonka day. Doing so in the under position is kind of awkward as you can't see what you're doing. And then you're left with this long, unpleasant to look at unrolled paper, which is not really on style. Additionally, when it's in the back, it's just harder to get at. And I don't know about you, but when I'm relaxing on the throne, the least amount of problems, please. I got enough to think of during my day. Having it over just makes it that much more easier to get to. Period. Hotels too prefer installing it over to be able to make the little triangle thingy to show that the room was cleaned. They'd have problems doing this if the roll was flipped over. And that pretty much covers it. For those that are under, I hope this video gave you a good laugh, but better yet, an incentive on the downsides to having it this way. It could actually get you sick if you're really unlucky. So think about it twice next time you go to grab your paper. There might be some nasty germs on the wall. And like I said before, I want to hear your way of doing it and why you do it your way so we could get some statistics going to see which way is really the best way. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, share with your buddies, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe for more cool upcoming videos. And until the next one, thanks for watching.